Welcome back, everyone, to another brand new 1v1 ranked video. I hope everyone's doing amazing. I hope you're all living your best life. As always, it's starting to heat up here. Last week, this rating would have been like third in the world. Now it's seventh, so there's seeing a lot more players. I mean, there's a big gap, actually, between seventh and the top seven players and the bottom, kind of the next seven, 50 points around that. We're getting very close to the 2400 rating, which is our next big objective right now. Our win rate is really good at the moment. We need to keep winning games, bumping it up even more. Who knows? We could go on a massive 20-game win streak and hit that 70% and 2500. That would be very clean. Make sure you hit the subscribe button if you're not already subscribed, guys. We're nearly at 9,500 subscribers. So 500 away from 10K. So smash the subscribe button and let's get into the first game. Okay, we are in. 9-5-10 is there. That looks ideal. But 9-4-11 is not bad either here. So either way, we should get on some ore. The wheat just makes this board difficult. It could actually be an 8-5-10, 6-4-2 play into the 11-4-9. Because you know 9-5-10 is not taking 9-4-11 here. And for him, it's, I mean, 9-5-10, 9-6-10 looks really nice. You do only have the 10 of wheat though. So this is maybe a little bit of a trap. Wow, okay. Or 6-5-10. This also works, but interesting. Okay. You do make my life a little bit more difficult than what I would like. This and this. I mean, it's going to take him ages to get into the 11-4-9, but I suck up all the wheat with this play, which is really interesting. I suppose he could play some 9-4-2 though, so I'd probably have to take 6-4-2. Does he? And he just plays this into this. Not ideal. Not ideal at all. I really don't want to give him 6-4-3 here. Damn, do we just take it? Huh? You know, we're going to just take this. Make him build into the 9 of ore. At least we start with ore. I'm not totally happy with it, but I think let's just play a bit more balanced here. We still have good road building. I was about to take 6-4-3, 9-5-10. I was. But this is still fine. I wonder if he's going to take 6-4-2 first. And maybe I take the double wood there? Question mark? No, but we want to start with the wheat. Tempted to point up here. Because if he does take 6-4-2 and builds that first road, if I point up here, I can still just take 9-11. And I can also get 8-10. But if he takes 6-4-3 and points right, then that 9-4-2 is available. And I've kind of pointed this road up for nothing. What makes more sense for... Do you guys think... I think he's going to take 6-4-3. Depends if he's... I think I would play the 6-4-2. 6-4-3 is like that one step. This is a big decision. All right. I think we're going to point left. I can still double road. All I need is a 5-9-9. These 9 rolls are key. The 10s roll... The 10 actually is pretty big, but it's also how he gets his wood. Yeah, so we do see 6-4-2. He has 0 roads right now. At least we have 1 brick. We both get brick on the 5. So I just need the 10 not to roll early. Oh, he buys a dev straight away. I don't like that. If that's a VP, can they please have a VP? 9 is huge. Oh, that's so big. Okay, so I actually need a 5. He needs a 5 and a 10. Unless he has a yop. Should I commit this road? Only 9 puts me over, but he could have a monopoly. I think we just got to play 4. Come on, roll that 5. There we go. Big roll. We get to cut him out of the ore. He used his only ore on the pop. Huge for us. Also big for our road connect. We cut him out of a lot of the board here as well. 10 is also a city. He did just roll 7 as well. Wow. I almost think we just go for it here. Ugh. The thing is, he blocks my wheat. Settling might get a bit hard. You know what? I'm going to go for it. If he plays the aggressive knight, good on him. 6. 10 would be massive. Another 6. So, okay. This is clearly not a road builder or a yop. Otherwise, oh man. That hurts, that 2. He'd probably just pop again, yeah. There's a 7 from us. We'll hit 8. I hope he doesn't play the aggressive knight. I think it's the right play if you're him. Yep, there you go. That's a 9. Nice. 5. So maybe this is a VP. Or maybe it's double knight. He just wanted to have one extra. All right, I'm happy to roll another 5 here. 6 actually gives me the wheat as well. That's a such a huge block. We just port our sheep here. We'll chill. He's holding a lot of sheep. He gets the settle. Seven is so big. The wood port's not doing a whole lot, but I think I will block the 10 here. Yeah, so I mean, I can settle here, but I also do like the pop. The thing is, if we get a VP or something, it's not ideal. So let's just take the settle. No kind of pulling a row builder yop. Let's just commit to this 11-4-9. 5-4-3 will be huge into 6-3 maybe as well. Otherwise, 6-11-3 is not bad. That's terrible roll. 7 and lose the ore. That's huge though. Wow, he didn't block the 10 roll so big. Yeah, I guess so. I guess the 9's fair. Okay, he's thinking. 6. Yeah, I mean, we don't have much else to do here, of course. That hurts. Where's that brick port at? Yeah, that's quite nice for him. Oh my gosh. He has spent all his ores though on development cards here. I mean, I think I'm going to do it. It sucks a little bit. That's a big card. I don't exactly know what we want a mono. He's going to pop again. He must be holding at least one VP. 10 rolls are big. 6. So he's wasted all his ore, and obviously we have one of the monos. It's going to be tough for him to get a city, I think. 6-11-3 should get us road, so that's probably our next objective here. He's going to come around for the 9-10. Another 10 rolls. I know he's holding a fair bit of sheep. Okay, never mind. That all the sheep goes. That was his last settle. 9 rolls, so we don't have to worry about any more settles from him. Yeah, we can commit this road. 4. We just need to roll a 7 and... yeah. 6 is probably the best hit here. He's going to steal a wheat from us. I mean, he's going to play a knight regardless. Knight. Good that he steals the sheep. 8. Ah, man, these 9 blocks are big. We might want to mono the wood. 7's actually perfect for us. He ports for an ore. I could mono the ore. If you're 2 rolls, that's the money right there. Let's go. All right, we definitely pop here. The VPs aren't bad. Okay, another mono. All right, so he might actually... that sucks. 2 monos, 2 VPs. I mean, yeah, we'll play on here. 5. I might take the... it's tough. 11. I might take his wood. What does that do for me, though? The wheat's also kind of nice. He's blocked my wheat. We're waiting on a 6. The ore port. I guess we'll come out this way. Yeah, this is fine. 3. Let's hold off on the mono for now. I think I'll mono the wheat. It seems... unless he ports for an ore. He's actually going to buy a development card. Wow. That is not ideal for him. There's our settle. Nice. So let's take that. I like this hand. We'll mono for the wheat soon. He's holding no ore, right? So he used that one ore he ported for. 7. 10 is the fattest roll. Like, he gets... that's how he's going to get the ore. All right, let's just not lose the ore here. Come on. He does take army. 7. Okay, nice. Lost both bricks, which is perfect for us. He doesn't have a 3-1. He's going to buy another dev. I think this is a mistake from him. That wheat mono is still there. I think he's holding at least 2, I think. 9 gives us 4 cards. It doesn't put us over. Let's just hold in case 7 rolls again. And that way we have a lower chance of losing the ore. 5. He does port for an ore here. So let's take the wheat. Yeah, let's just take the wheat here. And honestly, let's keep building. I think... to continue building is the right idea. The only problem is that we're just doubling nothing, really. Like, he's most likely just got more knights for us. All right. I'm happy to just grab the ore port here for 9s. There we go. We don't have to worry about a monopoly, which does feel good. 8. Yeah, so seeing that we don't actually have to worry about a monopoly, I need a 5 or 11 to roll. We'll just come in for the 8. Go all the way around. This is chill. I mean, 7, maybe he gets an ore, but I can mono it back. 10. He's holding 0 wheat, so there's a wheat. 4 rolls. Now it's interesting if we start popping now. I think we do. Let's see if we can put some pressure on him here. And having no 3-1 is going to really hurt him. He might actually port for ore. I think he will. He's holding 1 ore, 1 wheat. There's an ore port. Let's see if we can grab one of those ores from him. 6. Nice. That's beautiful. Damn, he rolls a 3 though. Yeah, let's put pressure on here. Right? He might run out of knights. He might only have 2 knights or 1 knight left. Okay, that's also really good. All right, 50-50 shot. Nice, he misses. Another 3. So he's now got 3 wheat, but he pops, so 2 wheat. Okay, that shows me he might have had no knights. 5 is nice. 3 VPs is very good for us. 7 is perfect. I guess we'll hit the 6. We do get a wood. Should I hold this hand? I actually don't mind popping again, but holding the hand. He's definitely playing a knight. It'll put us at 6 cards. 6 is fine. 10 is fine. Only 9 puts us over. All right, I'll hold. Just lower the odds of him getting the ore. 8 rolls. He's going to continue pieing the deck out, but I mean, there's nothing good, right? Do that. Ah, that's a good 7 right there. Blocks my wheat. That's what I need most. Once we get the 3-1, it'll feel good. And he's just, without the ore, I don't know what he's going to do. We have the ore port as well, so we've got a little bit of flexibility here. I feel like 6 hasn't rolled in ages. Nice, we get the wheat. Let's do that. Okay, so we're sitting at 12 points. 10 rolls are big. Obviously, I don't want him to steal the ore. How do we close this game out? We need a city. Like, we got to hold for the city. Nice, he stole the wheat, but he blocked a 9. That 10 is unblocked. There it is. That's a big money roll right there. We'll just go for the production now that we have the 3-1. I think let's just try close on settled city, right? He 7's out. Could be a resign here. No resign. Gets my wheat. He's going to just keep buying the deck out. I guess we could lose road. There's actually no reason for me to build the road either. 4, 7. The brick. We'll chill. Basically, we're just waiting for a 9 or a 10. He gets my 1 ore. All right, he's stopped popping. There's the 10 roll. Yeah, we should. Yeah, sure. All right, so now we just need to finish on... He's holding 1 ore as well. And he 7's out. That's actually perfect. So 9 is winning if he misses on the wheat. He's still holding 1 ore here. All right. Is this his city finally? Perfect city, actually. Nope, he got the yop. Okay, so that's probably all the ore and wheat out of his hand. You would think. 7, we'll hit the 6. We do get an ore. You know what? I'm happy to buy another dev here. Let's go for it. I don't mind the 9. He probably has 1 VP. Okay, there's the 9. 6. What can we mono here? Okay, never mind. He resigns. I think the wood mono gives us the win there. Big win. Plus 11 as well, which is really nice. One step closer to 2,400. Really solid win to start the video off as well. So many 7s. So many 7s. Really good pulls. And in that game, the VPs weren't bad. They weren't bad at all. The key thing was to get these 2 roads and cut him out of the 9 ore. And he just kept using the ore to buy more devs. I guess it's a good thing if you're pulling the monos, but if you... Yeah, I pulled both monos and I pulled all the VPs, so he's just losing at that point. And he's got no 3-1. The wood port's not that good on this board for him. Yeah, dominant win for us. Had a lot of resigns lately, haven't we? A lot of resigns. I took this city early because I looked up on the board and there was already 3 sevens and not that many rolls. So we took this early city, but I knew the aggressive knight could come into play. And I think if we look back, I think he did have 2 knights. So he popped. Oh no, he actually got the first VP. That sucks if you're him, using that one ore you got for a VP. And then he played the aggressive knight. Yeah, and he did block 110, so that was a nice block. But I don't know. I'm unsure about playing aggressive knights. And then he rolled the seven straight after, and he was able to get the momentum with the knights. Couple twos as well. But realistically, we should probably just have army and road that game. All right, good game. Let's get into the next one. All right, game two, ladies and gentlemen. You probably want to start with the nine wheat. I mean, so many great spots. The three actually might come in handy. The sheep's just a bit trash. Issues, you don't get the wood brick. I doubt 9-5-10. I mean, it's hard to play. Like, I guess 9-5-10, 9-10-11's not bad. It's actually quite nice. Maybe you just play 9-5-10 because you know you're going to get... I'm wondering if he does that and that. That would suck. And then I look like a fool taking this. There's just so many counters, aren't there, to... All right, let's pray. Let's just take the best ore and say, you know what, we have the best ore. Here I point up. I mean, if he's... I guess it's not the worst if he takes... I mean, he has one wheat spot. Potentially 9-5-10 is just better here. Because he's going to play this 9-5-10, 9-10-11 into 5-2-10. It just hurts. I might play the 5-2-10 so he doesn't have extra wheat at least. But then I leave 8-4-10 at the same time. Yeah, I mean, the wood port's here as well. It's not bad. I could play... this is probably the wrong play. I just got in my head a little bit. He could make a mistake, but I got in my head a little bit about, like, trying to defend 6-9-3, 9-10-11 to 5-10-2. This is different. Like, how does he get the wood? Okay, looks like we've been bailed out. I've said that before, though, and we've been destroyed. But this does seem really good for us. We're going to have great road building. If we can manage to get into here, I do wish I pointed left. I don't like what he's done. Having the three of wheat is such a weakness. If these nines are quiet, it is awkward for us though. I think you just point left, hoping to get 9-4-11. A bunch of eights could hurt. If we get, I mean, I do want this. This road hurts now. This is so good though. 6-5-12 isn't bad. It is an extra source of wheat as well. But you want to be getting into all this good stuff. Okay. Still a losable game. I think 9-5-10, 9-10-11 crushes us though. Let's see. 5-4-11, guys. Alright, I'm going to point down. Something a little bit different. That's a very nice big roll. I'm considering heading into 5-2-10 first, man. Let's see where this takes us. I roll a 5. Do I just protect the 9? In case of 8s. 9's the only roll that puts us over. I'll take a risk here. 4. He does pop. That could suck for us. Could also be really good. He's going to block my 9 of wheat a lot. Maybe we just get the 6-5-12, man. I really did want to protect this. Popping could be big. It's been treating me really well lately. Okay, let's pop. Far out. Damn it. The Aussie legend. Okay. This isn't good. That 3 actually gave him a wheat as well. He probably has a knight. Anything else is even worse. Mono is terrible. That's nice. A couple 5s would go a long way. There actually hasn't been a 5. He's going to go for this 6-4-11 first. Wow. Very dangerous of him. That does happen. The reason I want to get 6-5-12 is because of the extra wood. And road building is going to be important. Also, just the 12 of wheat. But I should just cut him off here. Let's just do it. Play a slow game. Wait for a 5. There you go. So the issue here is that I'm holding a lot of ore. A 9 roll gives me the city. It's interesting. I think we go for the 9 here. Here all 7, it's unfortunate. 8. 7. Okay, that kind of sucks because he'll probably play a knight. If he doesn't have a knight, though, it's big. Yeah. That's the issue with rolling a 7 there. And that would have been the VP if we didn't pop. Okay. 10. That 9 roll is going to suck when it hits now. Holding a lot of ore here. Hopefully no mono. He did pause there. Yeah, I mean... Fine. Yop is great. That's a really good card. So I do want to grab the ore port, but this... Should we just... I don't want any road builder plows. Okay, let's just head into the ore port. Gives us a bit of flexibility. He's blocking the brick. Ports for the wheat. The wheat is such an issue for him here. Like, it's crazy. He also doesn't have a great road path. But he does have the 3-1 now. Okay, wood port's happening. 4. I just want the 3s to stay quiet. 9 is such a big roll. Wow. We can just get the army pressure with 9. You know what? I think we... I can settle here, and 9 is still a city. We also just have the ore port. Okay, I like this. I like yopping for the settle. 6 is a free card. 9's a city. The city's too big, right, to give up? He buys another development card, which is interesting. Oh man, this 9 needs to roll right now. There's the wood port activated. That's not a pretty sight for us. We just need to dodge a mono, man. We really need to dodge a mono. 7 hasn't been rolled in ages. Damn. Okay, so a little bit of an issue here. We could port the ore and just pop. I think we're going to play it safe and just pop here. Don't be a VP. Nice. Yeah, I don't want a 7 out. Nice 6 roll. He did have the mono, so I'm glad we did port the ore there. That's not as bad for us. But yeah, we did really want to dodge one of those. I think we wait for the 7 here. Losing 1 brick isn't the worst. There you go. 3 is such a big roll. I think the 8's probably just better though. For now. Knight gets play. Don't roll 9 here. 7, nice. So I'm hoping a 3 doesn't roll. It's a bit risky. I think the 8's are more dangerous right now. Yeah, even just blocking this. I mean... Okay, the 3 it is. The 3 it is. 4 also hurts. It's a lot of cards. 10. I mean, he's got this kind of spot to come into. Do I just want to go for 10, 11, 3? I'm thinking about road as best I can. Let's get into this extra 6 and maybe the 12. The 9 is such a big weakness here, though. It hasn't rolled in ages. Can we get 1-9? Oh, there's that 8. That sucks, that 8. Oh, man. I knew I should have just blocked the other 8. And the plow happens. That hurts. He also does take road. We're a knight down. Not that great of a port for us either. No 3 blocks. Yeah, I mean, 2 8s. What are you supposed to do? We're dying for a 9 as well. Yeah, I can't pop. I can't just port my ore here. We gotta wait. 3, okay, that's a big block. That makes me feel better. But there's probably army. Come on, let's get a 9 here. 4. Porting the sheep isn't even good, man. But we've gotta just do it. We can't afford to be blocked here. That's probably gonna seal it for us. Especially, seems like he's holding something. Big 3 blocks. 9 is big here. But he's just out. He's just producing too many cards. Both ports. Very flexible. Probably will come in for road at one point. In fact, there it is right now. And we do not have army. Uh-oh. We just need to port the wood, unfortunately. The wood port's so bad as well. Damn. We need a knight. We need to start getting army. Just cannot buy a 9 right now. Yep. I actually don't know what to block here. Ah, and there's another. I don't know what to block, guys. The three hurts so much, but these eights, I mean, the six is there. Damn, I guess I just got to hit the eight and live with it. Six, all right. We get to buy another one. That's good. There's army, probably at 12 points here. Yeah, he can just continue to buy devs. There's really nothing I can do about it. Okay, fine. I'm hitting this wood because it becomes a card, even though that's his only brick source. All right, he doesn't have another knight. But he probably has the... I wonder what he's got cooking there. Four mono ends us. I suppose I need army anyway. But it's starting to get a bit ugly. Like, I need the city. Okay, I'll play it safe. There's army. There's the nine. So can we get a six? Seven's not bad. I think I'm actually going to hit the other six now. The brick. Come on, six. The other nine is very nice. Okay. And a seven. Here we go. Starting to cook. This four hurts so bad as well. Ah, let's run with the four here. Do something a little bit different. Damn, the no city is really sucking right now. Is he really at 13? Damn. All right. Okay. Eight. Not the worst. There's our city, finally. I think we're actually going to do this. Four. That's a huge block. Nice. He gets the dev. Five. This is a big decision here. Like, I do need to take army, but he can probably buy another dev. I'm holding a wheat and a wood, all both good steals. I'm not really stealing anything good from him. I think we wait here to try keep him blocked. Losing the wood is good. Now I just need him to not to buy dev. Nice. Okay, what's the key block? He still needs to get a city. The key block here, guys. Like, three is a key block. 10's also a key block, but 10 gets me the 3 ore. I think I'm going to run with a 3 here. 9 is very nice, but I can't actually get the pop off. 11 would be a huge roll. He only gets 1 wood from the 11. Okay. Don't roll 4 here. Damn, that 10, 7's actually not bad. And we lose the wheat. We're trying to fight back here. 4. The road builder. 3. Yup. He's most likely at 13. It's starting to pour down here in Melbourne. So this will be a city play, most likely. Damn. We don't get to hold road either. Okay. So this and this needs to happen for quick settles. We obviously need a pop. There's our knight. 10. I think that's just GG. He probably just finishes here, right? Somehow, 14 cards. Yeah, GG. That game was winnable. The nines definitely under-rolled to begin. Yeah, the nines definitely... Yeah, six nines. And they rolled twice, like, just early then. Shout out to Sasha. Yeah, no, yeah. We knew the nines were going to be key. How does he win that game with only a three of wheat? Like, seriously. Yeah, three rolled seven times, nine rolled six times. That's the story of the game right there. Oh, well, you can't win them all. You can't win them all. Maybe I could have blocked some eights that time I blocked the three. But that'll be it for today's video, guys. 1-1. I might play a few games in my own time. But I appreciate you all for watching, as always. And I'll see you all in the next one. Peace out.